Hey, what's up, world? It's your boy, G Shrimp, baby, by the faith, baby, daddy, the voice of the street, man. And today we in, we go be in New York, Jamaica, and Africa, y'all. Yeah, you heard me, Jamaica and Africa. And trust me, ain't none of these vacations. Now, I really don't know who to start with, but I guess we'll just start with the guy in Africa, y'all. Now, the guy in Africa decides, y'all, he didn't like his wife no more. He didn't like his wife. Now, let me tell you about this story here. This is a deep one. They came from Africa, y'all, and he became a preacher. And his wife was by his side, and he was doing his thing. He had a big church, y'all. He jumping around, dancing, had the dashiki on. He looked it real good, you know. But then after a while, he started getting more and more popular. He getting more and more cocky. It went from a loving marriage to a controlling one. And him just, you know, intimidating the woman. And then next thing you know, he started beating her up. And some of these battered women, they be so afraid of these men. I can understand. They be really afraid. And when somebody else interfere, it only make them scared because they know it's going to make the husband even madder. Don't you know this woman did all she could to try to leave this man, y'all. She did all she could. He started beating her up. She was hiding her bruises from her family. He was trying to isolate her from her family. That's the number one thing. That's how you know when something going on, y'all. When you got a family member that usually communicate with y'all, then all of a sudden, y'all don't hear from her in 2-3 days, then a week, then next thing you know, a month. You like, it's a month and you ain't heard from her? Then it's something that she normally would show up to, like y'all mama's birthday or something, and she didn't show up, and she used to be the one that throws the parties. Then you got to know something is wrong, right? So this woman was in this relationship, and she started getting tired, right? She tried to get her brothers to intervene, right? She goes to get her stuff to move out of the house, right? And she was scared to death. He came over there, and the brother was there at that time, and her and the brother got to arguing big time. They got to arguing big time, and he like, you gonna leave. You know, he said, this is my wife, I'm gonna keep her. He like, no, you're not. She's leaving you. And they argued back and forth. He said, you know what? That's your sister, but that's my wife. You know what? I'm gonna kill her. This is what he said, y'all. He said, I'm going to kill her. And, you know, dude, like, get out. The brother put him out. Man, the brother was so scared, he wanted to call the police. His wife had filmed it. But you know who was even more scared? The wife was. She walking around looking at stuff. Now, she done got everything she want, but she still looking. She talking about, I'm going to come back and get this. And the other man, her brother's wife, like, no, you're not. You go write all this off. We're going to leave this. She said it ain't nothing but debt. You can write debt off and you can replace it. The sister, she's sister-in-law trying to give her some good advice. She said you need to forget about all this. It's not yours anymore. Meaning don't come back here. And the lady like, but I don't want to. She was scared. She didn't want to anger the husband because she kept saying, but he going to be mad. She said, I don't care if he mad or not. You know. So they convinced this woman to leave, y'all. And the brother hung around and was making sure she go back and forth to work. But when you're not combat ready and you're not really looking for trouble, you're just, you know, it's business as usual. He figured he got her, drove her to work, you know, gets in front of the job, so far no so good. He gets out and he walking in and he walking in. The husband there all the time, y'all. Gets out of the car. The brother going in, he almost ahead of her. He should have been behind her, but hey, who's to say? He doing his part, y'all. I can't criticize him, you know, because he did think he was there to protect his sister. And he was a little few steps ahead of her, right? Would you believe the husband walked from the parked car, walked around and shot this woman 7 times, like 3 times in the head, and then got in his car and left. The brother's scrambling to try to save her. They calling the ambulance and everything to no avail. The lady died, y'all. She is deceased. Over with. You know where this guy is at, y'all. He goes home. Not the one in the apartment. He had another apartment. But he goes to the other apartment. He's sitting in there, you know, waiting on the police. They come. They surrounded. They got a SWAT team because they scared of him. They didn't know what he was going to be on, y'all. They didn't know what he was going to be on. Man, I'm talking about they came ready. You hear me? Ready. Had the SWAT team go in there and get him. And guess what? He come out with his hands up. He didn't want no problem. No smoke. I guess he figured already the kilter is over with. But I don't understand why a person would throw his life away like that. Okay, even if she wanted to leave you, you bad. But you could have got you another woman. He had a mega church, y'all. So he was bringing in a little money. It wasn't like he was starving. But sometimes these people, they love their wives so much, they be feeling like, if I can't have her, ain't nobody gonna have her. And that's not a good way to feel, you know. That's why they charge them with crimes of passion and give them breaks and all that, because sometimes you be so emotionally involved that you might just hurt somebody. Not saying it's right or wrong, you know what I'm gonna say. It's not right, it's dead wrong. But, you know, I'm talking about the court system. I don't know why they give them breaks like that, but they do. I guess they like when you acting off emotions, you always make a mistake. Even our generals, when we was growing up, that's how they taught us. Don't never act out of emotion. You calm down and then you could assess the situation so you can make the correct decision. Because when you do it when your emotions are wrong, you gonna make the wrong decision every time, y'all. You feel me? Alright, now let's move it on now, y'all. Let's go to Jamaica. Whew! You would think Jamaica, oh, it's so nice and beautiful over there. Everything is beautiful. Shouldn't be no problem. So this man got a wife, y'all. Everything going great. He loves her. He don't beat her up or nothing. He loves this woman. You know, they got 6 kids. And, you know, everything is going good. But something happened, y'all. And I don't know why or how he ended up getting a DNA test, y'all. But he ended up getting one. Not one. Not two. Not three. Four. Five. 6 kids he had. Would you believe ain't none of the 6 kids his, y'all? None of them. You heard what I said? One. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So she has cheated 6 times. More than that, but then when it counted, you can say 6 times you had kids. So ain't no telling how many times you have had sex with this person. But 6 times. And you know what he said, what really ticked him off, y'all? Is this woman had him paying child support for all 6 kids and ain't none of them his, man. Can you? None of them his. And then the ratchet chick had the audacity, y'all. You hear me? She had the audacity to come up to his job making the scene about child support and knowing ain't none of these kids are his. None of them. And I guess that just rubbed him some type of way, y'all. Guess what he did to her? He beheaded this bitch. I'm talking about where me knife at. Did I get me knife out, y'all? Oh, my God, I had it. Listen, he took the knife like this, and he chopped his head off. She got to go. Listen, he cut her head off 6 times. Now, one would have been sufficient, but I think he did it 6 times, one for every child. So that means when he cut her head off the first time, he put it back on, and he cut it off again, and he put it back on, and he cut it off again. 6 times, y'all. Do she deserve that? I am not gonna say because I don't want to lose no subscribers. I don't think nobody deserves to die. But hey, I don't think it's worth killing. You know, she got 6 children. Now maybe a good ass whooping and a divorce would have been suffice. But hey, that's just me. I try to think a little different. But he wasn't thinking clearly, and his emotion was involved too, y'all. So you got a Jamaican then beheaded his woman, and the African then killed his woman. Lord have mercy, what is going on? Y'all ladies, stick with American men. That might not do nothing but fuck your credit up and cheat on you a little bit, but you know. But don't get no husband like my girl Shirley Strawberry. Oh my God, y'all, he have really told this lady reputation up. And y'all know what they trying to do to Shirley Strawberry now, y'all? They trying to pull her into the case and act like she knew what was going on and that she was involved somehow. They want to try to make her seem like she is the mastermind. Can you believe that? Guess what, though? I heard she said she getting a divorce. Yeah, that would be the smart thing. Now you know Steve is probably talking to her. Look here, girl. I ain't got to tell you you need a goddamn divorce. You know that. Don't make me come back to town and have to tell you to get no divorce. You tell them people that now. Because I don't want, soon as I come to town, you get a divorce, people to be saying, oh, well, Steve made her do it. No. You know you need to do it. It was all right you tried to stand by the man with 5 little charges. But now he got 15 charges. But if you ask me, she should have been gone off the first 5 charges, y'all. Because one of the charges was him messing with a child or something. They found child pornography on one of his computers or something. They said he was fondling or touching on her daughters, and she got grandkids. And what else he had did? He had cheated and had the woman next door. Then he had the credit card fraud. She go stick by him on all them charges. They put a restraining order on him and told him he can't be around none of her children. And she was going to swallow that. And they didn't want him around animals. I told you that meant he had to be fucking some type of livestock or pet or something. Because they didn't just wake up and say, hey, you know what? Tomorrow, everybody come in my courtroom, I think I'm going to tell them they can't be around animals. No. They only say that when you are a danger to an animal. They don't want you out if you got a case having sex with dogs. They don't want that. You can't be sleeping with goldfish in your pocket and, you know, doing what you do, putting your penis in the cup, pleasuring yourself with that goldfish. You can't be doing that. You can't do it, y'all. You know, I'm telling you, you cannot do it. Do not pleasure yourself with no goldfish. Mm-mm. Don't do it. So she doing the right thing to get rid of her husband because he got to go because he making her look bad. Talking about a strawberry letter, y'all. Whoo, this bitch got a strawberry book. She ain't got a letter. See, a letter would be like this. Front, back, that's a letter. This bitch got a strawberry book, y'all. And I ain't talking about a little book, a big book. We ain't talking about a little Bible. We talking about the big Bible. Ooh, yeah, y'all know the old school ones with the picture of the Jesus on it, the white ones? Yeah, them. Them the kind. That's the type of book she need. A strawberry book. Now, let's go to the grand finale, y'all. What everybody want to know. What's going on? I had a subscriber this morning ask me about this person. And I told her I would look into it and get back with your sister. Well, in case you need to know, sis, I checked it out. Tory LANEZ, they gave him 10 years, y'all. You hear me? 10 years. That's bad, y'all. Oh, my God. They charged him with, look, possession of an assault weapon, a semi-automatic weapon. They charged him with that. They call it assault weapon. Assault semi-automatic weapon. Then they charged him with, what they charged him with, unlawful possession of an unlawful weapon in a car, in the vehicle, they say. Possession of an unlawful weapon in the car. Then they charge him with discharging an unlawful weapon. Oh my God. Anyway, look, that's three felonies right there. All three of them felonies added up to 10 years. See, you get a mandatory 1 year if you caught with a gun in New York, you know. 1 year. So 10, though? Ooh. But that's on you, Troy. Because, see, it's bad enough. You shouldn't be putting your hands on women. But you putting your hand on your firearm, whether it went off accidentally or whatever, I don't even care if you couldn't have whooped that woman. You should have never touched that gun, bro. Never. That don't make no sense. You done grabbed, now you done messed your whole career up because you grabbed your gun and fussing with it, and she might have tried to take it from you and went off. It might as well have been an accident. But the thing is, you should not have touched it in the first place, especially when you got bodyguards. Okay, you got bodyguards, and yeah, I know sometimes you want to tuck your own little pistol, but you don't aim it at somebody you sleeping with. No. You know what I told my grandkids, y'all, because they grew up in Chicago, and this is something I stood on them about. I told them, hey, never point a gun at nobody you love. And I'm talking about a toy gun. Listen, I caught him pointing a toy gun at his brother. I beat the hell out of him. You hear me? You know why? Because I want that in his mind. Never point a gun at nobody you love, whether it's a legal weapon or illegal. Never do that. And I told him, don't even point a toy at somebody, because you don't know what's going on with the devil and all this, and you'll be trying to explain to people, it's a toy gun, I don't know how a bullet come out of that shot, and ooh. Man, listen, don't have people trying to figure out what's going on with a toy weapon, why it shot a real bullet. You know what they say, the greatest trick the devil ever pulled was convincing the world that he don't exist. You hear me? I'm gonna say that again. They said the greatest trick the devil ever pulled was convincing the world that he don't exist. And some of you people that are Christian and all that, you go to church back and forth, how can you believe in God if you don't believe in his adversary? If you believe in God, you got to believe in the devil. You know what I mean? And from reading the book of Job, they would give one of their servants away every now and then to see if they could break you. Sometimes the Lord might be trying to test you to see how strong you is. He might know how strong you is, but he want to prove to Lucifer how strong you are. But ain't nobody going to call you and tell you you being tested. No. Whatever you going through, you got to go through it, bruh. You got to go through it. And just know it's light at the end of the tunnel. You got to just keep moving, dog. You can't stop. And definitely don't never give up. Trust me, never give up. Some of you guys, man, with social media and the jobs and the opportunity they got, y'all supposed to be all on this, man. You don't need permission. They don't have to hire you. All this stuff belongs to you. You own everything. I was watching the Mace and Cameron show, and they bragging on they little show and how much they own it, and they ain't got no sponsors. That's right, that's true. But guess what? I own all my shit too, y'all. Yeah. I own all my shit too. This is my house. You know what I mean? It's my house. It don't belong to nobody but me. These are my stories. I wrote this down, you know, I wrote all this down. These are what my subscribers ask me and want to know. If anything, I work for the subscribers, y'all. I don't have to, but it's my job to try to please the subscribers, so I do what they ask. You feel me? Now, y'all, hit that like button, man, and subscribe to the channel if you're new. Subscribe to the channel, you go like it, trust me. And y'all let me know what y'all think about this, man. Would you kill a woman if you found out all six of your kids, one none of them yours, and she been getting you for child support? Would you? Would you kill your wife just because she want to leave you and he didn't want her to go nowhere, because it probably would have made him look bad? The preacher been up there with his woman all the time. You can't be up there preaching and you can't keep your own wife in check. So he knew that was been a bad look. But you think killing her would have been a better look? Really? You think killing her would have been a better look? I don't know. Well, some of these people, they don't think right. I think different. What they say, think big, bitch. Yeah, I think big, bitch. That's me. Think big. You know, because you'll get there. You will get there, trust me. You got to do the work and just keep it moving, bruh. Do the work and keep it moving. And let me know what y'all think about Tory Lanez. Do y'all think he got too much time for shooting Megan in the foot? What'd he say? I don't give a fuck about your hole, your mole, your manicured toes. I bet you care not. And he a little dude. You know he a little dude. So I hope he know how to fight. Hope he know how to fight. But he got a little money. He should be alright. You know, they go cuff him. They go hold him down. You know, they go hold him down. Some people might want to test him, but some people might cuff him right away because they know he got money. So, hey, we need him. You can't be letting nothing happen to the bag. You got to cuff and protect the bag, you know. Hey, that's just how it is. And, man, when I tell you people can make phone calls and plug people, trust me. One of my guys, you know Kevin Gates was locked up in Chicago, Illinois. He went down there. Y'all hear him been using words like big old general, I'm one of chief men and all that. Only the generals can relate. Yeah, because he went down there and it was our guys that held him down. I know the general who sent the word, hey, hold him down, man. Hey, hold him down. Take care of him. And the guys got right on it. Hey, Mo, psst, you over here. And he was too popular to make a soldier. So he didn't have to do nothing but make him a general. You feel me? And that's eventually what happened. Because in our mob, you ain't playing with them words. If you're not a general, you better not be caught saying that. Because they will pull up on you, boy. They will pull up on you. Hey, man, who made you woo, woo, woo? All such and such, he better be somebody official. You better say, they say, who made you? Oh, G. Shrimp, all right. Better be somebody we know. They'll call me, hey, G. Shrimp, y'all made woo, woo, woo? Yeah, we held him down, all right. We're just checking it using your name, G. Yeah, he good, all right. Click. But don't you vouch for nobody that ain't official. You feel me? Nobody that ain't official, because that make you look bad and all that'll be on your name. You definitely don't want that, man. You know, hit that like button, man. Subscribe to the channel, man. It's your boy G-Shump, everybody's favorite baby daddy, voice the street. I'ma plant you now. Dig you later, man. I'm out.